Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2014 Polish war film called Warsaw 44. Spoilers ahead. Seat back, relax and enjoy the video. The movie begins with a man named Stefan extracting a tooth from his brother. As his brother runs away in pain, his mother collapses, but it is just a prank. Outside, he comes across a woman named Kama and handed him a gun as she continues to run away from the men running after her. Looking back at their house, Stefan dances which make his mother and brother laugh before leaving. Arriving at his work, he hides the gun behind the crates when an SS officer named Johann Kraus orders him to put some crates in his car. Not obeying at first, his boss steps in and orders him to do what the officer wanted. As he's about to load another crate, he's relieved to see that the gun isn't there anymore. Pissed, Officer Johann asks for Stefan's paper. Upon handing him the paper, he whips Stefan's face, wounding him. As soon as the officer leaves, the boss hands him the gun. He tells him that he'll not tell on him, but he won't work for him anymore. Afterward, Kama assures him that she'll give him a job and new paper. At home, Stefan lies to his brother about his wounds, and his mother walks out. The next day, he does the usual dance before leaving and meeting with Kama. Crybaby, a friend of theirs, picks them up and drives them to the factory, where he will work. A truck arrived, and beautiful women came out, but one particular woman caught Stefan's eyes. The next day, the group goes swimming. Allah, the woman who caught Stefan's eyes, swims to the other side of the river and refuses to leave. Being voted by the group, Stefan picks her up. At home, he wears his father's uniform and asks his mother for a dance, to which she agrees. While dancing, she made him promise that he shall not get involved in any rebellious activity. But the scene cuts to Stefan pledging his loyalty to the Polish army. After the oath taking, they go to practice shooting in which Stefan is good at. This impresses Allah. Later, Alexander introduces Stefan to his parents, and they reintroduce Stefan and Allah once more. At dinner, Stefan wants to leave because he's worried about his mother, but his friend says they'll stay until morning. Afterward, the boys are in the sauna, and they leave Stefan alone. Surprisingly, Allah walks in naked. Embarrassed, Stefan leaves and joins the boys in the lake. While the boys are enjoying the night, they hear explosions that make them excited. The scene changes to Stefan's mother freaking out because of him not coming home the other night and him joining the uprising army. With the trauma of the death of her husband, Stefan's mother breaks down and her children hug her. Meanwhile, Allah's father wakes her up, ready to leave the city to save themselves from the upcoming war. But she, along with his brother, stays. Back to Stefan, Kama is informing her of the upcoming battle and tells him to go to the factory. Allah, then, arrives and picks Kama. Stefan, on the other hand, proceeds to pack his things. As his brother sees him, he asks him where he's going, but Stefan cannot answer. Although he begs Stefan not to live, Stefan continues. Looking back, he does the usual dance, making his brother smile before leaving. The scene changes to Stefan meeting with his friends. Allah shows up and looks for her brother. Turns out, her brother, Alexander, is talking to other soldiers. He, then, introduces Commander Kober to his friends. Commander Kober tries to flirt with one of the ladies, but fails. Then, they proceed to talk about their plan in entering a school. After a brief reminder of their pledged loyalty to the country, they move out. Quietly sneaking inside the building, everyone is shocked to see one of their comrades is shot dead. Two of them shoot back, as Crybaby throws a grenade. Suddenly, Stefan moves alone. Although his commander stops him, he didn't listen. Barely managing to avoid getting killed, he's able to capture one of the enemies and free the hostages, wherein one of them wants to join the army. Commander Cobra, still, scolds him for what he did. At the base, he's assigned to guard the food. While the others are enjoying the night, Stefan is on the lookout. The commander asks his team why are they not drinking. Then, Allah and Kama volunteer to get some. Thinking they'll find drinks faster, the two separate. Back to Stefan, he spots an enemy, pointing his gun at him, he's ready to shoot. But he also sees Allah walking in the direction in the sight of the enemies telling other soldiers that he'll leave, he goes to Allah. Kama, on the other hand, arrives and looks for Stefan, but he's already gone. Meanwhile, Stefan, just at the right timing, sees Allah, and saves her. Their comrades arrive, and Stefan points to the location of the enemies. As the shootout takes place, Allah kisses Stefan before leaving. The next day, the commander scolds their group for what happened last night. And as per Stefan's punishment for leaving his post, Goral assigns him to do the dishes. The scene changes outside, wherein a commander tells them that the uprising will continue for more days than expected. Stefan, then asks him if they got comrades where his mother and brother live, to which he assures Stefan that they do. Then, he told him to get a gun and follow him. As Stefan and another soldier make their way to get a gun, enemies attack them. Stefan helplessly watches his comrades die. Collecting all the courage in him, he runs through the flying bullets of the enemies, but unfortunately, he got shot. It's already evening when he wakes up, and he manages to reach a destroyed home. Exhausted, he collapses and falls asleep. The next morning, he's shocked to see his mother and brother, along with other civilians, being captured by German soldiers. His mother sees him and signals him to stay quiet. Then, they kill them. Stefan watches as his mother and brother get shot in the head. Crying silently, the scene changes to the hospital wherein Stefan is confined. Although awake, he doesn't respond to any of his friends, even to Allah. Afterward, we see Allah in coma treating the young soldier that was once a hostage when he sees that the hospital is going to be bombed. Kama is about to go, but Allah tells her that they need to report it first, which she does. Unfortunately, when Kama reaches the office, everybody is busy. When she sees the commander coming, she reports about the hospital, and that they should rescue Stefan, but he refuses. He, then, reminds her that disobedience will result in execution. Kama immediately gets back to Allah, but she's missing. It turns out that Allah has already gone to the hospital to rescue Stefan. Removing her armband, they pretended to be civilians and asks for help. Then, Allah leaves Stefan on the sidewalk for a while to look for help. People around are celebrating because they caught an enemy tank and paraded in the street. Meanwhile, Allah is about to get back to Stefan after getting information on where to seek shelter when the tank exploded, and sends her flying. Standing up, she's horrified to see that it's raining blood and human parts, and she immediately takes cover. As soon as the rain ends, she quickly looks for Stefan, and cries in worry as soon as she finds him. Night falls, they're already in the shelter that the nuns run when she hears a soldier notifying another soldier about a retreat in the sewers wherein only soldiers are allowed. Taking her chance, she flirts with a captain to get some information. The next day, civilians are trying to get past the soldiers to the sewers, but Allah and Stefan are able to get past because of their armbands. The two manage to get into the sewers, but as a man tries to open a manhole cover, a grenade is dropped, killing many people. Luckily, the two survive, but Allah loses her mind. Stefan lets go of her hand, and she feels that she's being suffocated in a closed space. But she's able to get out of the sewers with the help of Stefan and another soldier. Then, they're brought to a refugee shelter where they clean up and share a kiss. Afterward, we see Allah wake up alone. She's surprised to see that people are in chaos, and quickly finds Stefan. Then, we see a Nazi prisoner being taken in custody to treat his wound. Stefan plans to kill him for revenge, but an old man already attacked and killed the Nazi. Outside, their friends arrive and Allah quickly drags Stefan into hiding. There, Franciszek and Beata get married. At night, the group is celebrating the marriage of the two, as Stefan and Allah quietly watch them from the distance. Then, Stefan stands up and asks Allah for a dance. While dancing, Allah shares his dream for the two of them to stay, survive, and live together. However, while sleeping, Stefan takes his armband and leaves. As she wakes up and realizes that she's alone, she immediately looks for Stefan. Asking everyone in the shelter, she just got more confused. Taking her chances, she talks and asks for a pass to the next city, as one of the refugees said, from the captain. But he won't give it easily, and sexually assaults Allah. She slaps him, but he slaps her back, ordering her to get undressed. But Allah smashes his head while he's getting undressed, takes the pass, and leaves. However, the border is already closed, and not even the pass would help her. Then, they heard an explosion. Distracted by the destroyed bridge, Allah runs past the soldier. Allah manages to get into a basement where refugees are staying, but Stefan isn't there. It turns out that he's with his friends, just like another refugee said to Allah earlier. They're with Franciszek, who just lost an arm. SS officer Johann Kraus is also there, talking bad about them. Another commander arrives, and Franciszek orders them to follow him. He, then, whispers something to Officer Kraus that makes him cry before leaving. Back to Allah, she's still in the basement with other refugees when they hear people from outside. Knowing that the people outside are Russians, they're relieved, but suddenly, they drop grenades on them. People start to flee, leaving a baby behind. Allah gets the baby, and immediately goes to the hospital. But there's only one doctor that attends many patients. Checking the baby, it's already dead. Allah, then, looks around, and sees the people suffering as she helps in attending the patients. Back to Stefan and others, they're on an operation when Allied soldiers suddenly charge. Unfortunately, only one of them survives the attack of the enemies, but Rogel dies in the process of rescuing him. Night falls, Stefan is smoking when Kama arrives, and smokes with him, and then they have meat injection game. Then, we see them infiltrating a building, and killing every enemy in sight. One unarmed soldier surrenders to Stefan, but he made him kill himself. The scene changes back to Allah, who's telling a story to the children in the hospital while attending to a wounded child. She, then, hears a soldier notifies another soldier about a retreat wherein only soldiers are allowed again. An attendant, then, gives her a bag, and orders her to go to the headquarters where she finally sees Stefan. She immediately treats his wound, then, asks the commander to evacuate everyone in the hospital, taking advantage of the ceasefire. The Germans allowed everyone to surrender, and will have a ceasefire for an hour. Everybody that won't surrender in the time being will be killed. After Stefan assures the commander that no one will surrender, he finally agrees. Then, we see the soldiers evacuating the patients. While helping a wounded patient, Kama and Allah talk and Kama states his hatred for Allah for leaving them. The scene changes to Stefan and his comrades, getting ready to fight off the enemies as the ceasefire ends. Meanwhile, Beata doesn't want to leave Franciszek no matter how much he insisted. When enemy soldiers arrive, and kill every Polish in sight, Officer Kraus introduces himself. Although he says that the Polish took good care of him, the soldier still wants to kill Beata and Franciszek, but the two have a grenade in hand. Pulling the pin, the two explode together. Back to Stefan and others, when the shooting starts, they manage to fight back at first. But as enemies keep coming through, and they start losing weapons and ammos, the favor of the war seems to be in the hand of enemies. The enemies, then, brought a tank, and shoots at them, killing Crybaby's girlfriend. Devastated, he tries to get to her, but Stefan stops him. When they see that the enemies brought a Panther tank, they decided to retreat. Stefan sees Goral about to wave a white flag, but Stefan stops him. The two struggle, but the commander stops them. He, then, gives the gun to Goral and leaves. Looking at his comrades and seeing hopelessness, he decides to lead his comrades to the river for safety. As they're about to leave, Goral shoots himself. Left with no choice, they left him. They quietly sneak around, evading every enemy. When they reach outside, they start attacking enemies on sight as they run. But one by one, Stefan watches as his comrades die in front of his eyes. It is just him and Kama that's left alive. Looking at each other, a tank arrives, and directly shoots her with cannon. Approaching the dying Kama, he begs her to live. But before dying, she's able to tell Stefan that Allah is still at the hospital. Then, one of his comrades turns out to be alive. But he sacrifices himself so Stefan could escape. Distracting the enemies, Stefan is able to hide. The scene changes to Allah still attending left children in the hospital when an enemy soldier arrives. Allah sits with them, accepting her fate. The enemy sits in front of her and removes his mask. Gesturing a kiss to her, we last see Allah crying. Then, cut to Stefan walking through the remains of war. When he reaches the hospital, he sees a pile of naked dead bodies. Unfortunately, enemy soldiers arrive and see him. When he turns around, he already has his gun in his mouth. Removing his mask, it turns out that the enemy in front of him is Officer Kraus. Snatching the gun out of his grip, he shoots the ground, and notifies his comrades that Stefan is dead. Stefan, then, continues running away. Reaching the river and manages to swim to the other side. There, he sees Allah waiting for her, and reaching for his hand, but it's just his hallucinations. Stefan, then, watches the city burns to ashes. The movie ends with the city engulfed in fire, transitions to a modern-day Warsaw city. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Have a nice day.